Well, hello there, wrestling fanatics. It's your host here once again. It is Team Rai, and we are gonna do the review of WrestleMania 32 live from Dallas, Texas. It just ended last night, and all good stuff. I have a guest here. He's gonna plug his social media and all hoopla. Go ahead, take it away, my guest.
I am the one person from the clique that is not at WrestleMania 32. I am We the PIWKO. On Twitter and my YouTube, you'll find it through my Twitter.
Alrighty then. Are you kind of disappointed that you were not there with your click?
Well, I mean, after seeing the actual WrestleMania, I'm glad that I went to 31 over 32, but it would have been cool to hang out with everyone the weekend. It's always cool to hang out with those guys, so to get another chance to do it would be awesome, but no, I really wasn't that... really wasn't that bummed out because I had a fun weekend myself going to a concert and stuff. I really wasn't that bummed out that I wasn't there.
So before we start our review, you think overall, do you think 31 was way better than 32 overall in your eyes?
In my eyes, well, I'm going to be biased about it. But yes, I would say 31 is better than 32. If I want to give an unbiased opinion, even Dave Meltzer and Brian Alvarez, if you know who they are,
yeah,
they said that 31 was better than 32. Obviously, if you're at 32 and you weren't at 31, 32, if you're there live, it's going to be amazing because being anywhere live is 10 times better, even 20 times better. So if you were there live, don't feel down on yourself or down on the show just because you liked it and other people didn't, because a lot of people going into 31 said that it was going to suck. And I know me and, especially Team Rival, we're all fired up 31, so don't get down on yourself if you're angry about people talking bad about 32.
Yeah. Anyway, the first thing, it was a pre-show, and they had, three matches, right?
I believe so, yes. They had a pre-show, and then a pre-show.
Damn, that's a lot. So the first match was, let me see here, what was it, U.S. belt?
It was Ryback versus Kalisto, and Kalisto was champion, and it was in an empty arena match.
Do you know why?
Yeah, because the ticket things, the power went down or something like that for the ticket machines, so
yeah,
they couldn't get anyone into the arena. And if you see some pictures and videos, I know the Real Classic 10 or something like this. I don't know what exactly his Twitter is, but I follow him. He's a good guy. Brandon posted a bunch of pictures of what the inside of the arena hallways looked like.
Uh-huh.
And let's just say, Rai, we had it easy at WrestleMania 31.
Really?
There was no fighting or anything to get into that arena on my end. I don't know about yours, but this was insane. People missed the first pre-show match. People missed the second pre-show match.
Wow.
And people even missed the beginning of the first on the actual card.
Really?
So it was insane. Yes. I know a lot of people who just got there in time, and I know a lot of people who missed the first couple of minutes of the first ladder match. So
wow. I heard from, Steven Brice, I watched the video. He says they were in line for 3 hours before they opened the doors. Is that true?
Yeah, they with their travel package, they took a bus, and the bus, because it's WWE, they want to get you there early. So they got there early. They were told to go one spot, but then they were told to go to another spot, and then the group got kind of split up, and it was just craziness, and I felt really bad, and I was tweeting the WWE, and I was saying, all right, well, if my network lags, I won't, have a problem with it if my friends can get into WrestleMania. It was insane.
Well, that's crazy. Okay, yeah, I did not watch that much, and I was wondering why was not a lot of people in the stands. And I just figured out later on in the evening, because the tickets was messing up,
Yeah, and
so,
it was just packed, and it was crazy.
And then I had a feeling that he was still going to win the belt anyway, Kalisto. He kept his belt. I'd be kind of disappointed if Ryback won,
Yeah, I don't know. This was kind of a, I wouldn't say a throwaway match, but, it seemed like it because, they started 10 minutes late than they were supposed to, trying to get people in, and no one saw it. So yeah, if Ryback did win, there'd be really no reaction at all for him.
Yeah. Next match was another pre-show match, correct?
Yes, it was.
It was the
second half.
It was the Usos versus the Dudley Boys, correct?
Well, actually, if we're going in order, it would be the 10 Divas tag team match. match.
Okay.
That was on right after the U.S. title match. So you want to talk about that one first?
Yeah, sure. You know what? That match was okay. I mean, there's nothing really to discuss, really, but, you know.
I know.
Brie, Team 1, you know, Team Bella. I mean, Total Divas won, so it's not really a big deal. Did you watch it, that match, or not really?
I'm going to be totally honest. I remember the entrances. I remember a couple kicks from Lana, and then that was it. I don't remember much of that match.
Okay, so I guess it's totally. That's why they put it on a pre-show.
Yep.
Okay. Then the last one on the pre-show is the Dudley versus the Usos. This is a pretty good match. Usos won. Then I think the Dudley boys went through a table, correct, later on in the match?
Yep, they did. They brought out the tables and they tried to put the Usos in them, but Usos said no. So when y'all say Usos, they said no, and they put them through the table. So that was pretty crazy.
Oh, yeah, it backfired. So I'm assuming this is going to have a rematch probably the next pay-per-view. Probably be like a table match. That'd be kind of cool. Now, the first match of the night, once again like last year, it's a ladder match. And it was a lot of great spots. A lot of people were disappointed because Zack Ryder won. But, you know, I guess it's like all 2011 all over again. And I was kind of shocked that he won. What about you? Were you shocked that he won?
Yeah, and first off, I was just really, really happy to see Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn, you know, with their entrances, and to just be at WrestleMania was awesome. And Sami Zayn got a huge reaction when he came out. Everyone was singing his theme, and I thought that was really, really cool. Good for him. You know, this match, literally, it came down to two people, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn, and everyone thought that one of those two were going to win. So the fact that Zack Ryder won this match was I think pretty awesome, because I liked Zack Ryder back in the day, and it's good for him that, you know, he's getting another chance, and it was a cool moment for him as well.
What do you think about Stardust honoring his dad?
You know, that was pretty cool at the moment, and then I heard that I guess Dusty Rhodes a couple, you know, years ago said he didn't want to be remembered for the polka dots.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's Cody Rhodes, or Stardust, excuse me.
Yeah.
You know, it's his son. So if his son wants to do it and thinks it's right, then I think it's good to go. But that was definitely really, really cool to see.
Okay, do you remember what was the second match of the night, Mike? Or Pico, sorry.
That's okay, go ahead. The second match of the night was Chris Jericho versus the person making his debut at WrestleMania, AJ Styles.
Yeah.
What did you think about this match as well?
I think it was a good match, but I was kind of disappointed that AJ lost his very first Mania. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, I'm with you on that one. And I was gonna do the thing. Do you listen to the Chris Jericho podcast?
No, but go ahead. What are you going to say?
Oh, no, I was just going to say, let me tell you about DDP Yoga. DDP Yoga. No, basically, Chris Jericho on his podcast always, like, he'll talk to the person, but then he'll cut in a spot where he does the advertisement, so he tries to make it sound like he's doing the advertisement right after talking to the person, and I always make fun of him for it.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, it's pretty crazy, but, I was really disappointed that Chris Jericho won. He didn't need to win. Nope. AJ Styles really, really needed to, you know, win this match, and it was a really good match, but that just the ending, it was just, no, like, Jericho did not need to win this match.
Yeah, do you think it's going to end this feud finally?
No, I definitely see AJ Styles having to beat Chris Jericho. I mean, anything can happen, but I feel like it's not done yet.
Man, but this is, they really like to drag it out, don't they, this feud? Man, WWE.
Yeah, I don't know, but I do want to say about this match, a friend of the show, Britton Harrison, he was at WrestleMania, and he got to see his favorite wrestler ever, Chris Jericho, win. So I just shout out to him because it was really cool that he got to go, and, you know, his first Mania, he gets to see his favorite wrestler of all time, Chris Jericho, win on, I mean, it was against AJ Styles, but still, it's Chris Jericho for him, so that's a cool moment that he'll always remember, so it was really, really cool for him.
Oh, yeah. Okay, next match, was it, I don't remember the order.
It was the League of Nations versus the New Day.
Now, I think, if you think about it, this was not a good match on paper. It wasn't, because I guess they changed it at the last minute, right? It was supposed to be a 4-on-3, right? A handicap match?
Yeah.
Or?
Yeah, I believe they changed it to a 3-on-3 sometime, like an hour before, or during the pre-show or something like that.
Yeah, but what do you think about the New Day entrance?
I was going to ask you about that, because that was really, really sweet. I saw a bunch of people tweeting about how, and even Britton was sending me the scoops of, like, because Britton, where he was sitting, like, behind the stage. So, like, for the pre-show match for the Divas, he saw Nikki Bella standing behind the stage waiting for the match to be over. She was in gear. He sent me the message about the New Day with the amazing huge box of Booty-O's. That was awesome entrance, and they came out. They looked like the Power Rangers, and, oh, man, it was such a cool entrance.
But, no one doesn't really give a darn about the match because it was not that great. But after the match, holy cow, HBK, Mick Foley, and Stone Cold Steve Austin. I was marking out. I was making on videos on Twitter. What's your quick thoughts on that, Pico?
The moment Shawn Michaels came out in his gear, the show could have ended right there, and
yeah.
I would have been fine.
Yeah, me too.
I marked out. I thought he was going to have a match. I was like, questioning myself if I should have been there. I was seeing if Luke tweeted anything, because I know that's a big deal for him. But man, like, that, I don't even know what to say. That was such a cool moment.
What about Austin and Foley? Were you surprised?
Well, I don't know. Foley, I had a feeling he was going to do something on the show. Since my stream was behind everyone else's, because it wasn't lagging, so I didn't care if it was behind or not. But I saw that Austin was going to come out. But I didn't know about Shawn Michaels. So when it happened. And I quickly ran over to Twitter. So I wasn't as surprised for Austin because I saw that it was going to happen. But it was definitely a really, really cool moment.
So you're more shocked for HBK than the other two, correct, Mike? Or Pico?
Oh, yeah, because Shawn Michaels is my favorite. And it was really cool to see him in gear.
Yeah, that was an awesome moment. Do you think WWE will ever make a real seal, the booty flakes or whatever, or no?
To be honest, that would be really, really cool if they did like a limited edition thing with like, I don't know, like some knockoff brand of Cheerios or something like that. But you know those t-shirts, you know the t-shirts they saw on WWE Shop in the box?
Yes.
Yeah, they're a real letdown.
Oh, they are?
Miguel, Freaking Area 88. He did the Periscope thing over WrestleMania weekend, and he showed like the box, and it was really, really flimsy.
Really?
And I was really, really disappointed, and I was kind of upset.
Well, they just want your money. It's what, $35 for that thing?
Something like that.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Okay. Next match. Sorry, we went a little overboard. I think it was what, Brock Lesnar and Dean Ambrose, right?
It was. Yes.
Now, I thought it would be a longer match. I thought when Dean Ambrose comes out, you know, like this, he did this past Monday, I thought he's going to have that, all his goodies in that wagon. He did nothing. All that stuff was prior to it, and it was underneath the ring. So what the hell, W?
I don't know. I wanted to see that wagon.
Jesus. I guess they just gave you hyped up for the match. I was disappointed.
Yeah.
And I thought Dean Ambrose was going to win this one, but nope. Lesnar won.
Yeah, I don't know. This was a weird, like, I was really bummed out because I wanted to see what, I wanted to see the wagon. Two, I wanted to see him use the chainsaw. And three, I wanted Dean Ambrose to win.
Yes.
So I was really, really bummed out about this. But it was too quick. It should have went on, it should have went a little bit longer.
I totally agree. It sucks. You know, it sucks. But whatever. But do you think this feud's over with?
Well, because Brock's probably going to be gone for a couple months until SummerSlam. Yeah, I have a feeling it is.
Yeah, one-time feud. Wow, but whatever. But what's next for Dean Ambrose?
To be honest, and this might sound like a WWE answer, we're honestly just going to have to wait and see what happens on Raw. Like,
yeah.
I have no idea what is next for Dean Ambrose.
Maybe okay, next match, I think it's a WWE Women's Triple Threat match, correct?
For the next one?
Yes. Yeah. Now, wait, what? Before we start, what's your thoughts on the new women's belt?
At first, I thought they were going to bring back the old one.
Yeah.
And then when I saw that belt, I didn't like it at first, but then after a while, I was just like, well, I mean, we're going to get used to it. It's better than that, the butterfly belt.
Yeah.
And now the divas are called superstars. So we can't call them divas anymore because they are superstars, Rai. So,
yeah, but they call women's, right?
It's a women's title, but Becky Lynch, Sasha Banks, Charlotte, Brie Bella, Paige, like, they're all superstars now. They're not divas anymore.
Well, they should call them that a long time. Does that mean the Total Divas, the name, is that going to change too, or no?
I don't know, but that's a good question.
Okay, now, I think this is a good match. Charlotte, the entrance is awesome. She has Ric Flair's robe from WrestleMania, 24, and it's awesome. Great pyro. I was kind of disappointed that Sasha Banks lost. She should have won. What's your quick thoughts on this match?
I mean, the trend for WrestleMania 32 was good match, but didn't like the finish and didn't like who won. Same thing with this one. It was fun to watch. It was a really good match, but Ric Flair had to get involved and Charlotte had to win. I was really bummed out after this, just like I was a couple of the other matches. But, I really wanted Sasha Banks or Becky Lynch to, win this match.
I don't think this is over for a long shot. I'm assuming they're going to have a rematch for the next pay-per-view, Pico.
Yeah, I think they're going to, Sasha Banks is going to keep chasing for the title. And I think at SummerSlam, Sasha Banks will finally win the title.
Okay. It was a good match. A lot of great spots. Charlotte had a great, awesome moonsaw. And probably just the best match for the women's in a long-ass time, Pico, you know? Besides the Lita and Trish back in the day. Okay, what's the next match? It's Hell in a Cell?
It is the Hell in a Cell Undertaker versus Shane McMahon.
Yeah, if Shane O'Mac wins, he has control of Raw. Now, this match should be the main event of WrestleMania. What the hell is WWE thinking, you know? Or McMahon, you know?
When I heard that the Cell was being brought down, I got really, really, really mad because I knew what was going to happen in the main event, and I knew how it was going to go exactly. And I was really, really upset, but what are you going to do?
Yep, but it was kind of cool how Shane O'Mac came out with his kids, you know, and all good stuff, and all that money came down. I know Jim Wright got some, and all the people, they took pictures on Twitter. I'm not too sure if you've seen it, but it's awesome. Two old guys, but Shane O'Mac did the coast-to-coast and bring back the Attitude Era, and he fell off the top of the cage, bringing back memories. Too bad Shane O'Mac lost, but what's your thoughts on this match, Pico?
It was a fun match. I don't know, a lot of people thought that it went too long, a lot of people didn't like it, but I don't know, I had fun watching it. It was cool to see Shane McMahon. I want to give a quick shout out to RKO, the infamous NWO, who got me a Shane McMahon dollar, so that's cool. I don't know, I had fun, and especially like the huge drop off the cage. Which was nuts, but I like this match. I didn't like who won. Again, I wanted Shane to win, but what are you gonna do?
Yeah, I guess it's gonna be the same old on Raw, but we'll find out weeks to come. I don't know. I'm just kind of disappointed. Now, speaking of disappointed, the main event, Triple H. No, actually, hold on.
But wait. There's Rai, you are missing everything. First off, we got the Andre and the...
Yeah, I know. I know. I forgot about that. Yeah, I know. And I'm surprised it's on so late in this show. Were you surprised?
I don't know. It was kind of cool because, it was on the actual show and it actually meant something this time.
Yeah.
So I thought that was pretty cool.
And the last time, it was going to be on a pre-show before the show kicked off. And they finally decided to put it on the main show. So it was a good thing. And overall, the NXT guy won. He came out of nowhere and beat Kane. So, what's your quick thoughts on that, Pico?
I think that's awesome. I think it's good for him. And I think that he'll do awesome on the main roster.
Now, they should have done that in the past. They should use a young guy, and he could be the help of his career. But they messed up last year and the year before, but whatever. I know they get Cesaro at WrestleMania 30, but he did nothing since, you know? And then last year for Big Show, the only reason they give it to him because they want to compete. I mean, they're going to want to compare with him and Andre the Giant, you know?
Uh-huh.
So, it was a pretty good thing, but it should be earlier in the show, but not so late before the main event. Speaking of main event, before we discuss the match, what's your thoughts on Stephanie and Triple H entrance.
Well, first off, you missed one match, actually.
I did what?
You missed Eric Rowan versus Dwayne The Rock.
Oh, yeah.
How can you miss that amazing segment, that amazing match?
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that, yeah.
Because I loved it.
Yeah, it's not on the card, but that was awesome. Holy crap. They broke a record. I think they broke a record from WrestleMania 3, right? It's confirmed. It's all broke, right?
They broke a bunch of records. I know that the official attendance for the people that were in the building was 97,769.
Okay.
So they didn't get the 101, but they weren't far off from it, so that's pretty good. But I know they broke a bunch of records.
But I thought it says 101 on the screen. Was that a lie?
They lie a lot about their amount of people.
Why? That's stupid.
That's just what they do. I don't know.
I don't know, but it's awesome. I love the train floor. You know how we burn the rocks thing? That was kind of cool. And he was in his wrestling gear. That was awesome. Did you? That was an awesome moment, Pico.
Yeah, that was a mark-out moment for me because I was like, oh my god, he's gonna wrestle. It's gonna be awesome. Like I'm never gonna get the end of this. Like this is gonna be nuts.
And then it only lasts about 6 minutes. So wow, I guess the Wyatt are just jobbers now. Jesus.
Yeah, well, I mean it's The Rock. What else do you want?
Yeah, I know, but it should be a better match. But I'm glad The Rock did something. And then guess who came out of it? Super Cena. He's back again. Say shit. And I thought he's going to turn, but I guess he's not going to ever turn heel, but that was a great moment. So
I like Cena coming out. I think that was an awesome way for him to return.
Yeah, but most likely he's going to come back tonight, most likely. Now we can discuss about the main event, right?
Yes.
Okay, now, before we discuss about the main event, what's your thoughts on Stephanie and Triple H's entrance and all that good stuff?
Oh, so cool.
Yes, it was. Oh, it reminded me of, I don't know if you're a big fan of He-Man, Evil-Lyn and Skeletor. Remember those back in the day, the cartoon?
No, I have no idea.
Well, you can look up on YouTube. That was awesome. And the match was okay, not really spectacular. The only thing, it was awesome when Roman spear Stephanie. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, it was cool. But, like, just as the match went on, and as it went on and Triple H didn't win, like, you know, longer and longer, and, you know, he wasn't winning. And so, I don't know, I just got really, really bummed out. And again, the Taker versus Shane McMahon match should have went on last, but what are you going to do?
Yeah, so it reminded me of WrestleMania 25 when Orton versus Triple H, how it ended the show, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't remember that match, but yeah, I know a lot of people have said that same thing.
Yep, see, that's McMahon. He wants to always want to mostly a title match to end the show, but I was not very happy. But do you think Roman Triple H is going to have continued feud, or do you think this is it?
Well, I think I have a feeling we're going to see whoever Roman is facing next tonight on Raw.
Okay.
So that should be cool to see what's next. But really, like, I don't know. I just don't like the fact that, you know, WWE or Vince McMahon just was like pushing it out there so long, and here this was just the rip of the Band-Aid. Like he pretty much, like, you know when you have a Band-Aid and you just rip it off like really, really quick. That's what Vince McMahon did for WrestleMania 32 main event. He just ripped the Band-Aid off real quick, had Roman, you know, be champion at WrestleMania, and he got what he wanted. And I don't know.
Yeah, pretty much. But it was a nice arena, huge. I don't know if WWE is ever going to go back there. Probably down the road they will.
Oh, God. All right, so here's that. I saw a lot of this, of people saying this. If Dallas ever gets another WrestleMania and is an AT&T Stadium, I know I won't be going. I know a lot of other people won't be going because I've heard nothing but horrible things about how that arena worked for WrestleMania.
Oh, wow. Was it unorganized?
Oh, people missed matches, right? Like, it was insane. Like, here, hold on, you can keep talking, but I'll send you that picture.
Okay.
Of what it looks like in the hallway.
Okay. But I think next year it might be a better thing, WrestleMania 33, probably.
Yeah, I don't know.
Are you going?
I'm sure it will be a lot better.
I know you said that you'll know if you're going or not because it's a couple months from now, right?
Well, as of right now, I'm not going. If something changes drastically down the line, then we'll see what happens when we get there.
Okay, but overall on the show, what's your quick thoughts on overall the show, Pico?
I had a lot of fun watching it, but that main event just really took everything out of me.
Yeah, I totally agree. They should do way better, and they had no weapons. Triple H had a sledgehammer on the side, but he didn't use it, so what the hell? I guess they promoted on their shirts, but they didn't promote on Raw or SmackDown, you know?
Yeah, I don't know what was up with that. That was really, really weird.
Yeah, I don't know, but... And no big, no Seth Rollins, no one help out, like, Shane O'Mac, no Bullet Club, nobody. I thought Sting will show up and help out Sting, you know? I mean, Taker, you know? Nobody.
Yeah, I don't know, but we'll have to see tonight what happens.
Yep. So, I really appreciate it, and, that's about it, really. You want to get any plugs or anything to your homies, your Click, if they're listening?
Shout out to Click 32. Click 32 is, it's a fun videos are coming soon, I can already tell, and, yeah, that's all I'm going to say, is go watch everyone's trip video. So here, I'll plug everyone. You got the Boston Brothers, you got RK of the Infamous NWO, Freaking Out 88, Salt and Battery 777, Burton Harrison. I can go all day. Nightmare 10, once again, the Awesome Lorenzo Bros, and I'm probably forgetting someone, but that's okay. So go watch all their Mania videos, because they're going to be awesome, I could already tell. And Breach is uploading them as they go, so...
All right. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. You have a good one. That's all I got to say. Enjoy this WrestleMania review and enjoy Raw tonight. Thank you, my guest, Pico, to come on board.
No problem.
You have a good one, and we'll talk to you on the flip side, everyone. Goodbye.